In this video, we will show you the circular array tool. You can find the circular array tool under the Arrays section on the Tools bar in the left area of the application. If you place the mouse on top of the Arrays section, you can see that there is rectangular array and circular array. We have already presented the rectangular array in a previous video, so this one is about the circular array. In order to use the array, you need to select something first. Let's start with this shape. When you start the array tool, a virtual preview of the array appears immediately. In reality, a virtual circle or arc is created and copies are placed upon it. The center is by default placed on the center of the axis. You can customize the properties of the array using these controls. Define the start and end angle of the arc or circle. If the start and the end angle are the same, a full circle is created. Now, define the number of copies that will be placed upon the arc. The step angle automatically changes according to the number of copies defined. If you change the angle, the array adjusts the end angle in order to fit the selected number of copies into this new angle. Using this checkbox, you can select if you want the circular array to be created clockwise or counterclockwise. Enable this option to mark the copies of the original object as clones. Stay with me till the end of this video for an example of cloned objects. Finally, using contour steps, you can select the number of added contour lines. When contour steps are added, you can select whether you want all circles to have the same number of copies as the initial circle, or add extra copies to make a better fit. Finally, using this drop-down menu, you can select a preset action for the array. For example, full circle preset. This preset will use the selected objects to create a circle with an array of them. This option is really useful as it automatically calculates the distance between the objects. Notice that if you have a work area applied, there is an extra preset to align that work area. You can also adjust the options of the array visually. The green line is the start angle, while the red line is the end angle, and all the blue lines are the inner copies. Moving the handle on top of the green line, or any handle on top of the inner blue lines, you can change the position of the arc and the distance from the center. Move any of these handles away from the array center to increase the distance from the center or decrease if moving towards the center. Using these nodes, you can also move the position of the arc. If you look on Tools Options pane, then you will see the new start and end angle according to the movement. When using the first control handle or any of the internal ones, you can enhance the adjustments using Control, Shift, or Alt keys. If you hold the Control key while moving any node, the movement of the array snaps on every 15 degrees. If you hold the Shift key while moving the first node, the arc doesn't change and you can only change the distance from the array center. If you hold the Alt key, the distance from the array center remains unchanged and only the position of the arc is affected. Moving the handle on top of the red line, you can change the end angle. The number of copies is kept as is, so in reality you also change the distance between the copies. If you increase the distance, the arc grows so that the same number of copies fits into the new arc. If you reduce the distance, the arc will shrink accordingly. When using the last control handle, you can enhance the adjustments using Control, Shift, or Alt keys. If you hold the Control key while adjusting the distance between the copies, the distance snaps every 15 degrees. This is great help when wanting to make accurate changes in an angle. If you hold the Alt key, you can change the distance between the copies, keeping the distance from the center unchanged. If you hold the Shift key, you can increase or decrease the number of copies, keeping the distance between them the same. Move your mouse to the outside of the arc and new copies are created on the circle towards the direction you are moving. If you move to the inner of the array, copies are removed. Actually, when moving the last control handle while holding the Shift key, you may define, using the mouse, the arc upon which the array will be placed. Using this handle at the center, you can move the center of the array. You can also move clockwise or counterclockwise. When placing the mouse on top of any control node, action handles appear. These handles appear highlighted not only on the current clone, but also on every two clones. It is like an X2 pattern, where for every two clones, one of them is affected. Now, press the mirror handle or rotate to rotate by 90 degrees. Use the handles freely to get the result you like, and when you're done, apply the array. Last but not least, if the Clone Objects option is enabled, you can edit any one of the shapes and have them all edited together at once.